confidence is surging, and our country is thriving and highly respected again. We passed landmark criminal justice reform into law. Everybody said that criminal justice reform couldn't be done, but I got it done, and the people in this room got it done. Members of Congress, we must never forget that the only victories that matter in Washington are victories that deliver for the American people. And my fellow Americans, the best is yet to come. Thank you, God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you very much.
A divided Congress in the chamber where he was impeached back in December. Kellyanne Conway is counsel to the president, joining us now live from the White House. Kellyanne, good morning.
Good morning, Sandra.
What is the president saying this morning as he sees the reaction we're all seeing this morning to that speech?
Well, the president knows the reaction came from the American public last night. I saw a CBS poll showing that independents overwhelmingly approved of his speech, and that makes sense because independents, by their very nature, reject partisanship. And the president was talking last night about the great American comeback, and that includes people of all walks of life. I think it's very disappointing for people to literally watch Democrats sitting on their hands, Nancy Pelosi shredding the memory of Kayleigh Mueller, shredding Tuskegee, 100-year-old Tuskegee Airmen, shredding a little 2-year-old Ellie who was born at 21 weeks and 6 days, and the list goes on and on. People sitting on their hands and rolling their eyes when a crying man with cancer was awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom. I think it shows you how petty and peevish and partisan the Democratic Party has become. And for all the people out there who fancy themselves the armchair psychiatrist trying to analyze certain people, they ought to shift their craft over to Nancy Pelosi. What is wrong with her? Who mutters to themselves through a State of the Union? And she looked like she was reading, the Cheesecake Factory menu all night, going through every single page. And then I think that she should either be censured, or I believe there should be the same woman who led a resolution in the House to denounce a tweet last summer. There ought to be a Senate resolution denouncing her behavior last night.
Is that your feeling, or is that the president's feeling this morning?
Well, you see where I am, and I will tell you that that's a feeling of many people who believe in the decorum of the United States Congress, the sanctity of the State of the Union. And I have to say, Sandra, I've been here from day one. Mm-hmm. And this is the fourth consecutive address to the nation the president delivered, including the joint session back in 17. For four consecutive years, the president has 90 to 120 minutes or so alone with the American people, on their computer screens, in the living room, at their places of work, on their phones, in the radio, over the radio. You know what he's doing? He's speaking to them unfiltered, uninterrupted, uninsulted by these people who criticize him all day long. And it's worked for him every single time because people get to hear what's happening in their country.
Look carefully, they're Democrats in the back, on the right side.
The content of the speech didn't leak ahead of time, and I'm very happy to say the guests have never leaked. Those guests in the First Lady's box, it's a very fine process commanded by a very small group of us. And you should probably run everything around here because the guests have never leaked.
I don't mean to talk over you. I just have a lot of I want to get to, and I know you have a lot to say, Kellyanne. So thanks again for being here. But when you look at the two big headlines that came out, sort of the bookend moments of that speech last night, you've already mentioned one of them, Nancy Pelosi tearing up the president's State of the Union address. That was before her as she stood next to the vice president. The president obviously had his back to her at the time. What did he say when he learned that that was happening and that that happened?
Well, that's typical her, that we've seen it here again and again. I've seen it in the Situation Room, saw it in the Cabinet Room twice, saw it in another meeting. She has a temper tantrum and then she leaves, but now the country saw it. There's no silly picture of her standing with all those men around the cabinet.
Okay, let me ask you about the moment that's
America
on the screen.
Saw an incorrigible child ripping up a presidential State of the Union that is meant for the people. It's meant to be delivered to the people.
Then there was the moment that before the speech, when the president walked into the room and he was greeted by the vice president and the House Speaker, she extended her hand to the president. He seemingly snubbed the handshake. He didn't shake the hand of the vice president, but we didn't see his hand extended because was that purposeful on the part of the president?
I'm not even sure it was purposeful. I'm not sure he even...
...in Baghdad when his Bradley fighting vehicle was hit by a roadside bomb That night he made the ultimate sacrifice for our country. To Kellyanne Gage, Chris will live in our hearts forever. He's looking down on you now. Thank you. Presidential Medal of Freedom.
The power of that arm with Rush Limbaugh, the soldier who came home, his wife and kids didn't know he's coming home.
That was amazing. Amazing moment.
Yeah, you see Limbaugh there, and there's the family not knowing until that very moment.
The soldier who came home. That was just an amazing moment last night. And what an honor it was to just talk to Kelly and her son Gage just now, because that moment really got me last night. They are incredible.